Hi everyone, my name is Kane and welcome to the BIM Academy. Today we'll be covering the module Advanced Schedules. This chapter explains how you can add more information and modifications to your sheets and schedules to meet your drawing criteria. This includes using templates to customize and suit your generated drawings. How to create schedules. First, let's open the following file main.dwg from the Advanced Schedules set from the exercise folder. Next, go to the project browser, onto the Files tab, hit the blue plus icon at the bottom, and select Import Schedules. Now, a dialog with a .dxt file should appear and should list a basic schedule template shipped in V22. If you do not see any of those, make sure it's pointed to the right folder. A .dxt or a data extraction definition file contains a customized preset of data types which you would like to include in your schedule. In this instance, let's select doors, bracket bim.dxt, and hit open. You should see your project browser refresh with a newly created folder called schedules with a drop-down value of doors, bracket bim.dxt. This means that this .dxt with its default settings is now loaded into your project. If you choose to generate a schedule based on its default settings, simply navigate to your desired sheet. And for this instance, let's go to A301, open sheet, return to the files tab, go on to the doors.txt, right click for more control options and generate on current sheet. This will take a few moments, but you should find the schedule generate at the bottom of the sheet for review. The schedule now appears as a table entity with the sizes and rows and columns fully adjustable to fit onto your sheet. With these control points, you can drag and adjust how they should fit on the sheet, or simply go onto the properties panel to adjust their width and height. As before, like in the basic chapter, you can move this table such that it fits onto the paper space above. Creating a new schedule. Whilst it may be possible to create schedules based on default, shipped, or pass.dxt files, there are scenarios where entirely new schedules are called for. For example, let's make a room schedule out of spaces. And to do so, we need access to the project browser again. So first, go onto the project browser, under the Files tab, hit the bottom plus icon, and hit New Schedule. Next, a dialog for the schedule wizard page should appear. And as we are creating a completely new schedule, let's rename our schedule to room schedule underscore training. This name will appear as your main header for the schedule afterwards. And click Next. On this page, you can choose whether you want to extract entities from blocks and XRefs. We don't want to extract entities from blocks, so we're turning this off, but we're leaving the rest of the checkmarks as they were. Also click to include current project. And before we move on, we have to make sure the right filters are being specified. And to do so, click Edit Filter. An Edit Filter box should appear, and within the field, let's type double equals bim underscore space. And to learn more about the .dxt syntax, please visit our BricsCAD help guide. But in this case, what we are telling BricsCAD to do is to filter out all spaces which are part of the bim entity customization. Let's go on to apply. And now the schedule format is tuned to filter out bim elements classified as spaces. Click on Next, and on this page, you can choose the properties to be included in the schedule. So space or room schedules are usually generated for purposes of understanding the area properties or even material properties. But for this exercise, we're going for the former, so that's the area properties. But to accompany these figures, we need to make sure other fields to be included should be relevant too. So let's pick on property equal to building, property equal to gross floor area, or to make it easy, simply hit the header up here to make everything sort out alphabetically. I go on to gross floor area, property equal to name, and also property equal to story. Click finish to acknowledge them. And this is now saved into the .txt file within your project folder. If you don't see this appear in your project folder, make sure you hit refresh to have the latest information updated here. Generating a schedule. So if you choose to generate a schedule based on the default settings, simply navigate to your desired sheet. And in this case, we are remaining on A301. So let's right click on room schedule underscore training and generate on current sheet. Like before, it's going to take a few moments and you should find the schedule generated at the bottom of the sheet. How to update an existing schedule. As you know, a .txt file is editable via the wizard as shown or via text editor. This exercise will cover the former, which is editing through the wizard because there's a lesser chance of mistyping or running into a mistake. Doing it via text editor may be briefly covered in the customized training. So in this case, let's right click on the .txt file and click on edit. The wizard dialog as we encountered before should appear. Filters on how extracts are extracted can be changed, but we are covering the fields instead. So click on next. Keeping with the existing field, let's select some extra properties which could support a basic area schedule. Again, you can click on the header to make sure everything is sorted alphabetically. And let's go down to property equal to UCS elevation, and also property equal to description. So now we are going to see where the space is located in terms of coordinates, and if there's any description to describe that space, it will be listed on the schedules. Once done, click finish. And this .txt file is updated in the background. Now, return to the schedule, select the table, and hover to activate the quad. Go on to select Update Data Link, and you should see the updates modify in a few moments. Like before, rows and columns can be fully adjusted to suit your needs. Alternatively, go onto the properties panel and make sure that the height is to your desired value. So in this case, let's take 400mm for example. If an A1 sheet is 594 by height, we can hit 594 and put on the width as 841. The style of the table can be fully adjusted under Table Style in Draw Explorer. So, like all styles, dimensions, etc., their graphic appearances can be adjusted to suit accordingly. Okay, that's it for this module. I hope you've enjoyed it. And thank you for watching the BIM Academy.